AEM 21-700C and 21-700P air intake systems are engineered to add horsepower and reduce restriction compared to OEM air intakes, and it comes with a lifetime limited warranty. AEM intakes utilize a reusable dry flow air filter. These oil-free filters are durable and very easy to clean. AEM 21-700C and 21-700P air intakes fit 2011 and 2012 Honda CRZ models with a 1.5-liter engine. See the AEM catalog or AEMintakes.com for complete model lists and details. These air intake systems are not legal for highway use in California or other states adopting California emission standards. Check AEMintakes.com for up-to-date information on emissions legality for specific parts on specific vehicles. AEM power testing showed an estimated power gain of 4 horsepower at 5,400 RPM with this air intake installed on a 2011 Honda CRZ with a 1.5-liter engine. Actual results will vary depending on the condition of the vehicle, mileage, weather, and other variables. Here's a comparison of the car sound on the dyno with the stock OEM system versus AEM's air intake. AEM air intakes come with detailed instructions with pictures and diagrams. AEM intakes are engineered for specific vehicles to produce a safe horsepower increase. Preparing the vehicle. Make sure the vehicle is parked on a level surface. Set the parking brake. If the engine has run in the past 2 hours, let it cool down. Disconnect the negative battery terminal. Raise the front of the vehicle with a jack. Refer to your owner's manual for proper jack and jack stand placement to properly support the vehicle. Support your vehicle using properly rated jack stands before wheel removal or while working under the vehicle. Never work under a vehicle without using jack stands. Do not discard stock components after removal of the factory system. Removal of the stock system. Disconnect the positive and negative terminals on the battery. Remove the battery, tie down, and cover from the vehicle. Unplug the mass airflow sensor. Release the clip securing the mass air sensor harness to the airbox. Remove the mass air sensor harness clip from the bracket on the PCV line. Remove the two clips securing the air scoop. Remove the 10mm bolt from the left side of the airbox. Remove the 10mm bolt from the right side of the airbox. Release the PCV clamp on the grommet and pull the PCV tube out. Loosen the hose clamp securing the airbox system to the throttle body. Remove the stock airbox system from the vehicle. Remove the driver's side front wheel. Remove the two clips securing the inner fender liner. Remove the four clips securing the fender liner to the bottom of the front bumper. Remove the Phillips head screws. Remove the Phillips head screws securing the fender liner to the side of the front bumper. Remove the 9 clips securing the fender liner to the fender well. Bend the fender liner out of the way to access the inner fender area. Use care so the fender liner is not damaged. Remove the top 10mm bolt securing the resonator. Remove the lower 10mm bolt securing the resonator. Remove the remaining 10mm bolt securing the resonator. Remove the resonator from the vehicle. Remove the 12 clips and the two Phillips head screws securing the belly pan in place. Then, remove the belly pan from the vehicle. From underneath the vehicle, locate the rubber valance on the driver's side behind the front bumper. The rubber valance needs to be trimmed on the driver's side. Separate the rubber piece from the hard plastic piece by pulling on the rubber portion until the nipples disengage the plastic side of the valance. Cut the rubber portion of the valance at the narrow section of the valance near the bottom. Remove the section of the rubber valance that was cut free in the previous step. Measure and mark 2 inches from the front of the plastic valance. Trim the valance along the mark, marked in the previous step. Remove the mass airflow sensor from the stock airbox by removing the two Phillips head screws. Place the MAF sensor and screws aside. They will be reused during the installation of the AEM intake system. Installation of the AEM intake system. When installing the intake system, do not completely tighten the hose clamps or mounting hardware until instructed to do so. Install the mass airflow sensor in the upper intake pipe using the stock MAF screws. Install the reducer coupler and secure the throttle body with a hose clamp. Slide a hose clamp onto the open end of the coupler. Insert the 90-degree fitting into the 1/2-inch hose. Insert the rubber grommet into the upper intake pipe. Insert the 90-degree fitting assembly into the grommet. Slide a hose clamp onto the hose. Install the upper intake pipe. Install a reducer coupler onto the end of the upper intake pipe and secure with the hose clamp. Slide a hose clamp onto the open end of the coupler. From under the vehicle, locate the illustrated bracket, then install the rubber mount. Install the middle intake pipe. Guide the intake pipe up into the engine bay from underneath the vehicle and attach the upper end of the coupler to the upper intake pipe. Then loosely secure. Align the middle intake pipe's bracket to the rubber mount installed in a prior step. Loosely secure the bracket to the rubber mount with the supplied washer and nut. Install the lower rubber mount to the specified location and secure with the provided washer and M6 nut. Install the 2.75 coupler onto the lower intake pipe and secure with the hose clamp. Install the lower intake pipe and route. Secure the end with the coupler to the middle intake pipe, while also aligning the intake pipe's bracket with the rubber mount installed in a prior step. Secure the lower intake pipe's bracket to the rubber mount using the supplied washer and M6 nut. Secure the air filter to the lower intake pipe using the supplied hose clamp. Connect the mass airflow sensor harness to the mass airflow sensor. Align the intake pipes for best fitment, and then tighten all hardware and hose clamps. Install the fender liner and any hardware that was removed in the prior steps. Failure to install the fender liner will result in diminished performance and increase the potential for engine damage due to water ingestion in rainy conditions. Install the driver's side wheel using factory torque specification. Install the belly pan. Reassemble the vehicle. Position the inlet pipes for the best fitment. Be sure that the pipes or any other components do not contact any part of the vehicle. Tighten the rubber mount, all bolts, and hose clamps. Check for proper hood clearance. Readjust pipes if necessary and retighten them. Inspect the engine bay for any loose tools and check that all fasteners that were moved or removed are properly tightened. Reconnect the negative battery terminal and start the engine. Let the vehicle idle for 3 minutes. Perform a final inspection before driving the vehicle. It will be necessary to check AEM air intakes periodically for realignment, clearance, and tightening of all connections. Failure to follow the above instructions or proper maintenance may void warranty. Go to AEMintakes.com to find products, download installation instructions, view dyno charts showing estimated horsepower gains, and for other product details.